We are now at the dimension intrinsicness, which is basically a dimension that describes a mode of experiencing any moments in situations based on where we believe the control or choice of experience may be. So there are two modes, one and two. The first one called the intrinsic mode, where the experience of happiness is determined by our choice and our control over our thoughts, emotions, notions, how we anchor, how we draw upon our assets, our purposes, our values, and so on. This is called the inside-out mode. So we have the control within us. It is within our mind, our brain, and no matter what happens around us, we can always choose and decide what to experience. So that's the intrinsic inside-out mode. The other mode, called the extrinsic mode, is where our experience of happiness is determined by choices and sources of control that come from outside of us. That is, we basically react to what happens around us. We react emotionally. We react to our thoughts. We react to our actions. And that is called the outside-in mode. So the control is believed to be outside of us. And therefore, whatever happens around us determines how we experience moment to moment. To illustrate this, the intrinsic mode or inside-out mode would be whereby in any situation, any type of situation, positive or negative, any interaction with people that may be positive in themselves or negative, so pleasant or unpleasant, or relationships or events, no matter what we may be in, what we ultimately experience is determined by how we choose our emotions or manage them, how we use our logic and think, what we decide to do, how we anchor ourselves into our assets, our self-esteem, or our values. And that's what we bring to a situation. So we basically act from the inside and bring it to the situation. So we may bring positive experience or negative experience. We may bring calm. We may bring courage, or we may bring nervousness and anger. So that's the inside-out mode. The other mode, the extrinsic mode, so outside-in, we basically react or experience what the situation may be bringing to us or triggering us from people, relationship. So we may react with disappointment, so an emotion, disappointment, anger, and so on. We may be influenced by others into the values of others, their purposes. We may or may not anchor ourselves into who we are because we basically live what the experience brings to us. So if it's mainly negative, that's what we live. If it's positive, that's what we live. So if somebody criticizes us, then we're filled with disappointment or with anger or with fear. Or if somebody praises us, it does the opposite. So in that sense, we react because the control is outside. So to determine what mode you may be in any situation, so any moment of a situation, which you could ask yourself several questions. For example, you could ask, is my experience of happiness determined by my choice and control of thoughts, emotions, notions, etc.? Is my experience of happiness determined by choices and control that come from outside of me? So the former here would be the intrinsic, and this one the extrinsic. Another question could be, do I draw upon my own attributes, or do I anchor myself, or do I use them and bring them out? Or do I draw and get influenced by those of others? Again, intrinsic versus extrinsic. Another question would be, is my anchor for happiness in me, so my own attributes and so on, values and purpose, or are they always coming and influenced from people around me, so from around me? A question could be also, do I bring happiness to situation, or do I expect that it will come from situation or get them from situations? Again, here would be intrinsic, and here would be extrinsic. Or am I acting on a situation or reacting from it? So inside out, intrinsic, extrinsic. So once you have learned to determine what mode you are in, you can note answers to this question and note whether you are in the intrinsic or extrinsic mode. On the 3A mindset template here, and then you could see, after having done that for all dimensions, how a particular mode here would influence how you feel, what you think, even how you sense things in your body, how it relates to the mechanisms you use, what you do, etc.